Hi there, and thanks for joining us. I'm Alexis Rogers. Just hours ago, the Supreme Court handed down their decision allowing former President Donald Trump to stay on the 2024 ballot. It comes down as a unanimous ruling rejecting states' attempts to keep him off their ballots as a response to the January 6th riot at the Capitol. It marks a win for Trump, who remains in the lead for the GOP primary race. On social media, he wrote, quote, "Big win for America." The White House has declined to comment. Well, the decision comes just one day ahead of Super Tuesday, when Minnesota voters join several other states in a day at the polls. Most polls open at 7 a.m. tomorrow and close at 8 p.m. If you still want to vote early, you have about 5 more hours before polls close today. Minnesota is one of more than a dozen states holding primaries tomorrow, with more than 2,200 delegates up for grabs. Well, right now, thousands of Twin Cities janitorial workers are on strike. It began just 6 hours ago in downtown Minneapolis. The union is expected to picket for 3 days at over 100 buildings across the metro. This group is made up of people working at different offices in the area as well as at MSP. Leaders say that they've been calling for new contracts for months. In those, they're asking for better pay and a retirement program.
About 67% of our members have reported that they have no savings at all. And so the only way to have a real retirement for the folks who keep our downtown safe and protected and clean are to make sure that they have employer-paid retirement.
The next negotiation meeting is set for this Friday. Well, today also marks 1 week from when St. Paul Public School teachers could go on strike. Union leaders tell us they spent 40 hours working with the district and mediators over the weekend. While they tell us they made meaningful progress, they have not reached a deal. In a statement, the district says it's committed to avoiding a strike. Now, we're taking a live look over the metro after a record-breaking weekend. We're back in the 40s today, and Ben has a look at some rain and snow chances this afternoon.
Well, coming off of yesterday's record warm temperatures, things are a lot more tame this week. You can expect maybe a few flurries or sprinkles around the Twin Cities metro, but most of what's falling from the sky today is in the southeastern part of the state and into western Wisconsin. Less up and down temperatures this week. We won't have nearly as wild a temperature swings as we saw last week, but we will stay on the mild side. In fact, temperatures today will stay in the mid 40s, which is still about 5 to 10 degrees warmer than the average high, which is actually still in the mid to upper 30s. Here's the next 12 hours. You can expect more clouds and sunshine today, but clearing is expected later this evening. Temperatures peaking again mid 40s today before we fall back below freezing tonight. Clearing tonight, that'll lead to a sunnier Tuesday. We'll have more on your forecast coming up.
Ben, thank you. Take a look at this map from the Minnesota DNR. It shows our current fire danger updated just this morning. Most of the state is in the moderate category, but there are still some areas in the high or very high categories. That's an improvement from yesterday's map. Take a look at this, showing a large portion of the state in that very high range. Michelle Beck shows us why there's still a risk.
Well, we're not out of the woods just yet. As you can see clearly, no snow cover plus those dry conditions. Take a look at the powerful impact yesterday in Waseca, ravaging more than 1,000 acres, according to state officials. It was so big that our weather team even caught it on the Twin Cities radar. We now know the fire is under control, and getting there took aircraft dumping water from above, plus multiple agencies responding from the ground. The sheriff's office says it all started yesterday afternoon as a small brush fire that rekindled from a prior burn day. But as meteorologist Ben Derry helped put into context for us today, fire danger isn't as high today as it was yesterday. In Minneapolis, Michelle Beck, KARE 11 News.
New at noon, we now have more details about what happened in a double murder at a Super 8 motel back in January. Police now say that the incident appears to be a random act, possibly triggered by the suspect's use of meth. Nicholas Linnaeus is accused of shooting and killing Shelby Tretel and Patrick Royers in the January 9th attack. He was later found dead from a self-inflicted gunshot wound. A toxicology report shows he had methamphetamine in his system, and in interviews, investigators learned he had previously indicated he may have been experiencing a mental health crisis. Well, today, police are looking for the person who shot at a Ramsey County deputy during a car chase on Friday. It happened in St. Paul's Dayton Bluff neighborhood. Police say a dark-colored sedan was driving recklessly, and when police tried to stop them, they took off. Shortly after, a Ramsey County deputy spotted the car and a chase began. That's when authorities say a passenger leaned out of the window and shot back at the squad car with a rifle. The deputy had minor injuries after he was hit by shrapnel that came through the dashboard. Authorities have found the car, which is now being processed for evidence. Well, the U.S. is calling for a ceasefire in the Israel-Hamas war by this Sunday. The calls come as the U.S. drops more aid in Gaza. NBC's Ralph Sanchez is in Tel Aviv with the new pressure from the vice president.
We are now 150 days into this war, and with the crisis in Gaza deepening by the hour, Vice President Kamala Harris issuing a new call for an immediate ceasefire. This is some of the toughest criticism of Israel we have heard from the administration yet. The vice president calling the situation in Gaza a humanitarian catastrophe and saying that Israel needs to immediately allow in more aid. No excuses, she said. Now, over the weekend, the U.S. dropped some 38,000 ready meals into Gaza by parachute. The vice president says they will drop more aid in the coming days. But Palestinians say they don't need aid dropped from the sky. What they need is the U.S. to pressure Israel to stop the bombing, something Israel says it will not do until Hamas is destroyed. Now, over the weekend, ceasefire talks continued in Cairo, but an Israeli official tells me one of the key obstacles at this point is Hamas's refusal so far to release a list of the surviving hostages. Raf Sanchez, NBC News, Tel Aviv.
Raf, thank you. Back here in Minnesota, a new opioid outpatient clinic is now open in Roseville. Today is the first day of the new clinic run by Community Medical Services. The organization says it's targeting a location where the need is great. The center offers same-day walk-ins and immediate access to medication-assisted treatment. It was a rough winter for ice anglers, but if you manage to get out and get an ice house or out on the Minnesota lake, today is the day to bring it back onto land. The DNR says anglers in the southern two-thirds of the state have until midnight tonight to remove those houses from the ice. They're also warning you to clean up any trash in the area. If you have a shanty in the northern third of the state, you have until March 18th to remove it. But it is a big week for basketball in Minnesota. When we come back, organizers of a celebrity wheelchair basketball game are here to tell us how it will help open more doors in our community.